In this video, we're going to see how to use the Animator component to move the player. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hi everyone, this is Omar Balfaki. If you're a subscriber, welcome back. If not, welcome to this channel where I create game development tutorials and from time to time I upload my short films. So if you're interested in these kind of topics, hit the subscribe button to join the community. Today, we will see how to use the Animator component to move the player instead of depending on code. The only code we're going to cover is just a couple of lines to trigger that animation, and the animation will be the one responsible for moving the player. And before we start, you just need to have a character with three animations at least. The idle animation, the walk forward, and the turn right or turn left animation. If you don't have that, it's alright. You can just go to the asset store and get the raw mockup data for Mecanim. It's free, so you can just download it and start using that. Let's get started. If you drag your character from the project window into the scene, we will see that the animator component comes with it. And the animator depends on two other components, controller and avatar. Controller is a component that's responsible for the logic of the animation, which animation should be played at the moment, and all the relationship between one animation and another. And avatar is the configuration of the bones, which bones are which. So before we get into controller, let's just see how to set up an avatar. Usually avatars are created by default, but just let's see how it's created. If you select our asset in the project window and we go to the rig tab, we will see animation type. Animation type is the character type. In our case, it's a human, so we select humanoid. If it was a dragon or an animal, for instance, we would choose generic, and then we will specify and assign these bones. To configure the bones for the avatar, just click the configure button here, and yeah, we're gonna save that scene. And it will take us into this window, a new scene with this window on the right side. So basically here we can test it out. We've got two tabs. The first one, mapping, where you're gonna assign each bone, and then we go to the muscles and settings, and here you can test them out. So you can just play with these parameters to see if the avatar is assigned. Once you're satisfied with the results, just hit done. So we're back again. Now let's see how to create the controller component. Just go to the project window, right click, create, and then animator controller, and let's just name this player animator controller. And then we select our character again and just drag that here. So now we've got ourselves a controller. To start adding the animation, just double click the controller here and it will open a new window, the animator window. We can edit and add all the animations and the relationships. First thing we need to add is the idle animation. Right click, create state, and then empty. And then from here, you can select the motion. We're going to choose idle. And now it's in orange color, which means it's the default animation. So if I hit the play button, we will see that our character goes directly to the idle state. Just going to change the name to idle. Just move them around. Here we have our idle animation. Before we go into the walking animations, we will need a parameter to go from idle to walking. To create a parameter, you go to the left side, just go to the parameters tab here, and click on the plus icon to add a new parameter. You've got four types: float, integers, booleans, and triggers. We will need a float, and here we're going to store the vertical input value. And then we're going to use these parameters with conditional logic to go from idle to walk, and from walk back to idle. To add the walking animation, since we've got three directions, forward, left, and right, we cannot just create one state for that. Instead, we're going to create a blend tree. So right click, create state, and new blend tree. We're just going to name that walk forward. And in the idle animation, right click, make transition, goes to walk forward, select the arrow here. And there is no condition. So we're going to add one condition. If vertical is greater than 0.1, we will go from idle to walking forward. and we don't need an exit time, so just remove that. And then we're going to make backward transition from walking forward back to idle, and it's going to be the opposite. If vertical is less than 0.1, we're going to go back to idle animation, and we're not going to need exit time. For now, walking forward is empty. So double click to see. There are no animations here. To start adding these animations, select the blend tree here. And as you can see, blend type is set to one dimension, which is going to depend on one parameter, which is vertical axis. We want it to be dependent on the horizontal input, left and right. So I'm going to create a new parameter for that, float, and just name it horizontal. Change it to horizontal here. And we're going to start adding the three animations. Add motion field. And we're going to start assigning them. Here, we're going to assign the left animation. If we go to animations here, we will see walk forward, turn right. So I'm going to select this back again and just drag for the left and the right side. And on the left, I'm just going to mirror it. So it will go left side. And then for the walking forward, I just have it here. Simply drag it. And threshold is the value of the parameter. If it's 0, it will play the turning left. If it's 0.5, it will walk forward. If it's 1, it will go right. But we don't want it this way. We want it, if it's negative 1, it will go to the left side. If it's 0, it will walk forward. I'm just going to uncheck automate threshold here. And I'm going to reassign them negative 1, 0, and 1. So if we play, you'll see that the player is standing in idle mode. If I change vertical to 1, the player will start moving. And if I change horizontal to 1, you'll see the player moving right. If I change it back to 0, the player will walk in straight line. Now we're left with the last step, how to control these variables or parameters using script or player's input. So for that, I just created a simple script. First, we just reference the animator in a variable named anim, and then we set the float parameter vertical to the input axis vertical, and then horizontal to the input axis horizontal. As simple as that. That's what it does. And then you will see the anim field here. We just drag the animator component, and that's it. So hit play, and let's see. So the player is moving just fine. So that's it guys for today's tutorial. I hope you like it, and let me know if you want us to go even deeper than this with Mecanim and Animator. And if you got any questions, just leave them in the comments below. If you're not subscribed yet, hit the subscribe button and remember to check the bell icon to get notified whenever a new tutorial is out. This is Omar Balfaki. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.